Hi everybody. It's really late at the moment. It's actually just before 1 a.m. And it's the early hours of Monday morning. I'm a little bit dishevelled, a bit stubbly as you can tell. It's not been, sorry, I'm just going to adjust the sound here. Just give me a second. Sorry, I'm going to get my hand out of the way. There we go. So I'm a little bit tired, a bit dishevelled, a bit hairy as you can see. And I feel okay-ish. I've just had a week off work and I'm about to go in to work in just a few hours actually. I have to be up at 6, so I'm going to try and keep this brief, or as brief as I possibly can. I've not done a vlog for a couple of weeks because last week I wasn't particularly well. I think I just got a little bit burnt out with everything, work and just the fast pace of life in general, really. It's not that I'm not coping, because I actually am. It's just I've had a lot of time to think about stuff. Quite a lot recently, and especially the last sort of few. The last sort of few months, especially, since the inquest, etc. I've really kind of had to step up and be the kind of person that not only I want to be, but I deserve to be. I think a lot of that has involved letting go of certain things and certain people as well, which is never easy. Obviously, as I'm sure you're aware by now, because I've mentioned it multiple times on my Talking Makes a Difference page. And that is my relationship with my dad is pretty much non-existent now. I kind of feel good about it. I didn't think I would feel quite as positive as I actually do. Because one thing I've realised in the 43 years that I've been on this planet is that he's the one who has mainly dragged me down. All because I won't bow down to his ideal of what a successful life is. Now, if I was, say, 14, 15 years old, then yeah, okay, fair enough. I might then understand where he's coming from. Because, my life hadn't, wouldn't yet have started properly. I'd just be starting to find myself, and I was at that time, but now you're talking nearly 30 years after that age. I haven't been 14 for nearly 30 years now. I'm now in my 40s. So I think I've earned the right to be whoever I want to be, whoever I deserve to be, I don't think anybody has the right to dictate to you about who you should and shouldn't be, because at the end of the day, it's your life. It might sound harsh, it might sound a little bit militant or selfish even, but it's true. At the end of the day, you're only going to live your life. So you live it the best way you can. And I think one reason why I'm starting to feel this way is because I'm starting to realize the weight of certain things that I've been carrying, the weight of certain people's negativity that I've been carrying as well. Because I mean, I love my father, right? Okay, I'm gonna make no odds about that. Yes, I do love him. He's my father at the end of the day, he's my dad. You know, he's partly the reason I'm in this world. You know, obviously my mum is the other part, and she's sadly gone now, so. But what I'm basically trying to say is, I love him, but I don't have to like him. Because I think you can do that, but I think I just can't be around him at the moment. Whether or not that will change, I don't know. I mean, he's getting on a bit now himself. He's, you know, almost 75 years old. I'm going to be 44 years old my next birthday, so we're both getting on with each other. So, what I can't do is feed off any more of that negative vibe that I always get from him. I can't do it. So, I'm gonna have to let go and I've come to the end of the line with him in terms of relationship. So, he has actually made the decision to end our relationship and cut ties with me. That's fine. I don't have a problem with that. If anything, I actually feel all right about it. Because now it's given me the time and the space to figure out what I want to do with the rest of my life without someone like him holding me back. You know? But you see, I'm part Indian, so for me, there's always kind of been like a cultural responsibility in a sense, in that, you know, you're not supposed to disrespect your elders and all that kind of stuff. But he's disrespected me my whole life, right? He's disrespected me my whole life and never once attempted to understand me. So why should I carry on with him? The very person who kept the family together, which was my mum, she's dead now, you know. And she's been dead a while now. You know, it's getting on for 18 months. And I realised, I think, after she died, I don't have to put up with his bullshit anymore. So my purpose of doing this vlog today, and the reason I'm doing this vlog, is to let you all know if you have someone in your life that brings you down, that devalues you, that dismisses you, ignores you, whatever, you need to let them go if you can. Not always easy, especially with family, but sometimes it's necessary. So my message to you today is basically this: be yourself. Refuse to bend to other people's expectations, because once you do that, you lose sight of who you really are. So stay true to yourselves, take care out there, and I'll speak to you next week. Okay? Bye for